Hey guys, Erin Wester here. So, as you can see, I just finished double workouts for Shift Shop, and I wanted to come on live and give you my honest review of the first week of the program. So, as an update on what's going on with me and my health. So, as most of you know, I've been sick for about 2 weeks now. I started with some kind of infection, not infection, some kind of virus, and turned into, well, as I found out on Friday, an upper respiratory infection. So, I get one sinus infection a year. I thought that's what it was, but my doctor was on vacation this week, so I couldn't just get my Z-Pak refilled. They made me come in and see a nurse practitioner, and they said it, my sinuses really weren't that bad. I was swollen all in here. My breathing was raspy. And yeah, if I wouldn't have gone to the doctor and gotten medication, who knows what it would have turned into. It could turn into bronchitis, pneumonia, and you never know. So it was a good thing that after being sick for like 12 days, I actually went to see a doctor. But last week I had been pretty off on my workouts. I was doing my last week of Country Heat and Shaun Week, and I just honestly didn't finish. But sometimes we have to take care of ourselves first. But I know a lot of it was making excuses. A lot of it was letting depression come over me. As you guys know, I have a history of depression. I lost my daughter almost 2 years ago now. It was November of 2015. I lost my daughter Alex's twin sister Victoria in November 2015. So we're coming up quickly on the 2 year anniversary. But I suffered from depression probably since I was about 13 years old. But it's not bad enough that I feel I need to be medicated. I use social media a lot to get things off my chest. I talk to my husband a lot. I talk to my boss. I talk to my parents. I have people to talk to. And there's times when I really think I should find a support group. So I'm actually going to be working on finding myself a support group to go to. There is a support group at Children's Hospital, but it's Monday nights, and that's really difficult since I live in Lake Geneva. Yes, I work in Milwaukee, but I don't really want to stay in Milwaukee all day and all night to go to support group. So I'm going to look for some kind of support group closer to here, maybe one that meets on the weekends or something like that. So that's kind of the goal, is to find some kind of support group. So, that's what had been going on with my health. Even though I hadn't been feeling the greatest this week, it was really just sinus stuff. I wasn't really coughing anymore. So I did do day one through four of Shift Shop. Straight through exactly how it's supposed to be done. Monday through Thursday, I was up at 5 a.m. I did my prayer, my personal development, my positive aspirations, and then I worked out. And I did that Monday through Thursday, but by Friday, I just couldn't do it anymore. I had called and made an appointment on Thursday, and I couldn't do it anymore. I was like, no, I can't get up at 5 a.m. I slept in. My boss let me work 9 to 3 because of all the extra work I've been putting in this week, because we actually sadly had to fire somebody. It was my first time firing somebody. So doing that, she had a caseload of 52 people trying to divide it between everybody. My caseload doubled. People freaking out. It was just a really stressful week. But I think my 5 a.m. workouts Monday through Thursday really helped. But by Friday, I was spent. I had to stop. You look at me now, I'm a sweaty mess, but this is me. I'm a hot mess mom. I'm badass mom. That's me. I'm not the kind of person that before I do my video for you guys, I'm gonna do my hair, put on makeup, get all dressed up. That's not me. I'm not putting out something that's not me. This is me. Weekends are workout clothes for me. Hats do better for workouts for me because it gets in my way and it's not long enough to put up. So this is me, hot mess mom, busy mom. I have a son who's 10 who has type 1 diabetes, so that takes up a lot of our time. Her daughter is 21 months old, so she's coming into the terrible twos. We have a dog, 11-year-old border collie. Besides my husband, all our family is close by. So that's me. I'm a hot mess mom. I'm busy. I'm a working mom. I'm a supervisor. So work is busy for me. I supervise 8 people. We have a caseload of 430 clients that I supervise. So I'm busy. I'm a busy mom, but I always put the time in for myself. And I used to be the person that always says, I am not a morning person. There's no way I could get up at 5. But then I think about when I started my journey back in 2009, I had to get up at 5 a.m. to get my workouts. Back in 2009, 2010, Beachbody really only had workouts like P90X. That was like an hour workout. So I had to get up at 5 a.m. to get my workout in and get ready and get to work in Milwaukee. It's where I live. There's really not a whole lot of social work jobs. So generally, I have to drive at least an hour to work. I drive 45 minutes now, which isn't horrible, but I mean, it's still a commute and it still takes up an hour and a half of your day. So, I was like, no way, I'm not gonna be able to get up at five. I had been getting up at 5:30, but that was a struggle. I wasn't always doing it. And then, I would be too tired at night and I just wouldn't get it done. So 5 a.m. has become my sweet spot. I've gotten used to it. Even on the weekends, I'll get up at like 6 and try to and go back to sleep. Or this morning, I got up at 5:30 and went back to sleep. It's just that's kind of ingrained in my mind that, I get up early. That's just what I do. So honest review of Shift Shop. So as you guys know, in May, I started a high fat, low carb eating plan, meal plan. And in May, I lost 15 pounds, which is a lot for a month. I know it's a lot. So you always think, well, you lost 15 pounds. How are you going to keep that off? Well, the last few months have been super stressful with work. I'm going to be honest. I started as a supervisor in April, so it's been stressful. So I'm going to be honest. I haven't 100% stuck to my meal plan. I've had beer, I've had wine, I've had carbs, and strangely enough, I only gained 3 of those 15 pounds back. So when I took my weight for Shift Shop, it was, oh gosh, I don't even remember what my weight was. But I was at 205 pounds when I was at my lightest at the end of May. And at the last Sunday, so a week ago, I was at 207.6 pounds. So as you see, I gained 2.6 pounds of that weight back. Or yeah, 2.6 pounds. But I have a feeling that I lost that weight this week because even if I haven't 100% worked out every single day, I've got every workout in. But even though Friday, Saturday, I didn't work out, I stuck with my meal plan. And my meal plan is different than the Shift Shop meal plan. I tried to follow it for a few days, but just with the way I'm used to eating now, it didn't work for me. Obviously, those just starting out, I am going to greatly suggest you follow the meal plan as it is. It's absolutely amazing. They have sample meal plans for every day that will follow the exact amount of containers you're supposed to eat, which I think is genius. It's wonderful. Obviously, you don't have to follow it 100%. You can make substitutions, and if you decide to join me in 2 weeks when I'll be attempting my second round, but lots of people will be starting there first, I can help make suggestions for you, tweak it for what works for you and your lifestyle. But for me, I've gotten so used to this high fat, low carb way of eating to a point where I haven't had to track my macros, and I know what I need to eat and what's good for me because I did it for like a month. I tracked. I know exactly what kind of meals to eat. And for me, I intermittent fast, so I only eat from 11 to 7. So that's another thing is that I was having a hard time getting all the containers in because that is with a 5 meal a day type, like 3 meals and 2 snacks a day type meal plan, and that doesn't work for me. But I've been doing this for 7 years. I've been doing Beachbody programs. So for those starting out, absolutely follow the meal plan. But for me, it just didn't work for me. And that's okay. The workouts work. Let me tell you, I have burned so many dang calories. I feel great. My inflammation has gone down. I have no joint pain. Workouts are challenging, but there's modifiers and it makes it doable for anybody at any level of fitness. For me, obviously, I'm a little more advanced. I've been doing Beachbody workouts for seven, well, more than 7 years, actually 8, because I started doing P90X in 2009. So yeah, I've been doing Beachbody workouts for 8 years and followed meal plans, done Weight Watchers, used the Portion Fix system, which absolutely works. But there is going to be a point, no matter what diet you're doing, that you're going to hit a plateau and you're going to have to mix it up. You're going to have to change things. And that's the beauty of making a lifestyle change is that it's not a diet. You want to figure out a way of eating that works for you. And if it stops working, you hit a plateau. Yeah, honestly, you need to switch it up. You're not going to just keep doing the same thing, even if it's not working for you anymore, because our bodies will get used to what we're doing. Our bodies get used to what we're doing, and then it's just going to stop losing weight. You can be working out for hours a day. You can be counting your calories. You can be using the containers to a T. You could be doing paleo, Whole30, whatever, keto, whatever you're doing. I don't label myself on any diet. I just eat a higher fat, low carb diet. It's not 100% keto because 10% carbs does not work for me. It just doesn't. Now with my workouts, I'm a 15 to 20% carb person, and I know exactly what I need to eat. I'd said peas are my splurge. Peas don't cause me inflammation, but peas are a carb, and for me, I'm just trying to limit my carbs. I'm trying to get my carbs from leafy veggies like asparagus, kale, romaine, cauliflower, and fruits like blueberries, strawberries, raspberries. Those are where I try to get my carbs from. And my Shakeology, obviously, I have vegan Shakeology every single day. And with Shift Shop, I'm also using the Beachbody Performance line. The first week it says not to use hydrate, so I hadn't used hydrate until today just because I was doing a double workout. But I've been using Energize every day. The first day I did not use Recover, and I was miserable. My body was so sore and tired, and I was starving by 9 a.m. when I usually don't eat till 11, and I have been doing that since May. But every other day when I had my Recover right after my workout, I know I'm probably technically breaking the fast by doing that, but it made me full until 11 when I would have either my lunch or my Shakeology. It just really depends on what I have going on. So for me, when I go to work, I bring my lunch, which is generally leftovers from dinner from one of the nights of the week, and my Shakeology mixed up, blended, ready to go. Generally at 11, I have my Shakeology. That's generally how I do it, just because of my schedule. And then about 1:30, 2 o'clock, I'll have my lunch and go home and eat my dinner at like 6, 6:30. And that is just what I eat. I mean, I haven't had coffee. Oh, I haven't had coffee for probably almost 2 weeks now. So I haven't had coffee. I do put Focus Energy in my Shakeology. So yes, I use a lot of Beachbody products. So I use the whole entire performance line. I use vegan Shakeology, and I use Focus Energy. Focused Energy. I think that's what it's called. So yes, I use a lot of Beachbody programs. I use Beachbody On Demand to stream my workouts. I don't have the Shift Shop DVDs because I don't need to, because as a Beachbody On Demand member, I get every single new program that comes out. But honest review of Shift Shop, you guys, it is a life changer. Chris Downing is funny. He makes the time just fly by. Again, it's doable no matter what fitness level you're at, because you can super push yourself or you can modify. This week I used 8 pounders. Next week for week two, I'm going to be upping it to 12 and a half. I'm going to try to up it to 12 and a half for most things. Focus Energy is kind of like giving yourself a caffeine spike. So instead of having coffee with tons of sugary creamers like I like it, I put my Focus Energy in my coffee. So it's like a ca caffeine type thing, but healthy. Like coffee, I think it has coffee bean, coffee berries, or so. I don't know how long is Shift Shop. Shift Shop. Okay, the first week the workout are 25 minutes. But it ramps up as the weeks go on. So week two is 35 minutes, week three is 45 minutes, which is going to be rough with my 5 a.m. workouts, but I'm gonna get it done. I may actually get up at 4:45 for week three, just so I don't have to rush myself. Yeah, I am a huge coffee drinker, and let me tell you why. When I was in college, I worked at Starbucks for my undergrad and my graduate degree. I worked at Starbucks. So I worked at Starbucks for 3.5, 4 years. When I was going back to school, at one time I wanted to get a counseling license, so I was going back to school for that. And during that time, I worked at Starbucks at Target. So I am a huge coffee person. But if you're not a coffee person, that's cool. And for me, I most often drink vegan cafe latte because it just makes me think that I'm drinking coffee, even though I'm not having my coffee with my super sugary creamer. That's just me. Right now, we only have vegan vanilla. Our cafe latte is gone, and we won't have more for a few weeks. So, yeah, I'm an absolute coffee addict. I'm a caffeine addict. So breaking that has been rough. So the Focus Energy really helps me with that. Yeah, so that's really where it's at. So I have 2 more weeks of my first round of Shift Shop, and then I'm starting round two. Anybody who wants to join, obviously, is welcome. You just can't be working with another coach. You either have to have the Shift Shop DVDs or you have to have Beachbody On Demand. And, there's different ranges of price for that. We can obviously talk if anybody is interested in joining me in 2 weeks. So I hope everybody has a great Sunday. I went way longer than I planned on it, but everybody have a good day. Bye, guys.